May be seated. Remember, if you stand to do video, just remember who's sitting behind you. We are videoing it live on the YouTube page, and I know the rest, several of you are videoing for Facebook, but so there should be some copies around. Well, friends and family, we've gathered together this evening, this afternoon, really, in the presence of God to celebrate and to witness the marriage of Miss Barbara Nigh and Don Smith. There's something very special about two people finding each other in their senior years. If I begin to make personal remarks, I'll cry. Don, I've only known you for a few weeks, but I have watched Miss Barbara's life for several years now. And there is none more godly than her. What a statement. She seeks to please the Lord. She loves everyone without fail. What a testimony. We pray together. Father, I want to thank you that I have the opportunity to be a part of this ceremony today. I pray, God, more than that, that your Holy Spirit would have the chief part. And that, God, what you do will be for your praise and honor and glory and for the good of this couple as they commit themselves to one another for the remaining years of their life. Lord, I ask you to bless them now. Bless this time together. In Jesus' name, amen. Well, as Barbara and Don come together today, they've considered what it means to commit themselves to one another. They realize what they're getting into. I told them if they didn't know by now, I couldn't help them. And that's true. The Bible tells us, submit to one another out of reverence for Christ. Everything starts with that relationship with Jesus. To experience the manifold blessings of God. It goes on and says, wives, submit to your own husbands as you do to the Lord. A lot of times people like that word obey. But really that word submit and obey in the original language means to line up under. It means to recognize your position. It's not a lesser position, but it's to recognize your position. And so wives recognize their position as the Lord. The husband, Brother Don, is the head of the wife as Christ is the head of the church. What a responsibility. His body is the church, is his body, in which he is the Savior. And as the church submits to Christ, so also wives submit to their own husbands in everything. Husbands, love your wives just as Christ loved the church and gave himself up for her. So really a wedding is a call to die for the man. It's a call of sacrifice. It goes on that Jesus did this to make the church holy, cleansing her by the washing with the water through the Word. And he's certainly here talking about the Word of God. But our words can be very cleansing, neutralizing the things of this world. It says, and to present her, there's a goal here, Don, to present her to himself as a radiant church. In other words, your goal is to keep her spotless and clean so that when she stands before the Lord, you've not taken anything from her. You've added to her. Without stain or wrinkle or any other blemish, but holy and blameless. When I read these scriptures, it seems almost heavy-handed on the husbands. But God declares that the husband is the head. And as Jesus sacrificed his life, bring the church into being, and when one day come back for the church, it's the same. Don, would you repeat your vows after me? And I'm going to ask you to, if you can, to speak up so the mic will pick you up because we are recording live. And I'll say it in short phrases, and you just repeat what I say, okay? I, Don, take you, Barbara.
I, Don, take you, Barbara.
To be my wedded wife. To have and to hold,
to have and to hold
from this day forward,
from this day forward,
for better or for worse,
for better or worse,
for richer or poorer,
for richer or poorer,
in sickness and in health,
in sickness and health,
I will cherish you as long as we both shall live,
as long as we both shall live.
One more little phrase here. Before God and these witnesses, I give my solemn vow. Before God and these witnesses,
I give my solemn vow.
Yes. Barbara, as the church submits to Christ, so also the wife submits to her husband. And when the husband loves the wife unconditionally, that's not a problem. This does not mean that you'll be dominated, but you'll be cared for in a way that you will respect your husband and follow his leadership. Barbara, would you repeat your vows after me? They're the same. I, Barbara, take you, Don, to be my wedded husband, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better or for worse, for richer or for poorer, in sickness and in health. I will cherish you as long as we both shall live. Before God and these witnesses, I give my solemn vow. Well, as a lasting remembrance of this time and the vows that you have made to one another, you each have chosen a band for one another. Though small, these bands have large significance. Like the precious elements from which they were fashioned, they remind us of the rare nature and the value of enduring love. Each time you see these rings, you will be reminded of this day and the promises you have made. Don, would you place the ring on Barbara's left hand? And repeat after me. This ring is a symbol of my promises. To you and to our God. Barbara, would you also place the ring on Don's left hand? And please repeat after me. This ring is a symbol of my promises to you and to our God. All right. The Bible tells us that a cord of three strands is not easily broken. Matthew tells us that a man leaves his father and mother to be united with his wife, and the two become one flesh. So they are no longer two, but one. But that third strand is God. What God has joined together, let no man seek to separate. Father, today I thank you for these vows. I thank you, Lord, for the recording of the vows with the rings and what these two are committing to one another, and what a blessing it is to be a part of this day. I asked you that you would bless Don and Barbara as they have presented their vows to be husband and wife. I pray that they would be, that their home will be strong and dependent on you. I pray that your grace and mercy and unfailing love will guard and bless this new family. In Jesus' name. Barbara and Don, because you have now forever joined your lives together as one, you've pledged your faith and love to one another and sealed your vows in covenant with God. I also seal this marriage by the authority of Jesus Christ and in accordance with the laws of this state. I now pronounce you husband and wife. Don, you may kiss your bride. I now present to you Mr. and Mrs. Don Smith. And so everyone is invited to join the happy couple for reception down the hall. Would you join me as I give thanks and ask God's blessing on the meal? Father, thank you for this time of celebration. Thank you for the food that's been prepared. Thank you for what you're doing here today. And for your glory and honor, we ask your blessings in Jesus' name. Amen. So you are dismissed.
Two hearts can come